It is the number one issue. If you ask any dental technician or any laboratory owner, the number one issue they have with dentists is definitely under reduction. We've had 30 years of a pretty good thing in dentistry. And I think it's time that we have to step up to the plate and kind of do our job. And I think this picture on the screen kind of illustrates this. This is a screenshot of a dental technician here at the laboratory measuring the reduction that's been done for an Emax crown on a molar and sent in by a dentist. And you can see that the laboratory technician can simply click on the prep tooth and the opposing tooth. And when they click on these two spots, it tells them that there's 0.85 millimeters of reduction. Now, as you'll see in a minute, we need a minimum of 1 millimeter of reduction for Emax lithium disilicate on a molar, and preferably more. So with this minimum of 1 millimeter, the lab now has to call the dentist and say, hey, we don't have enough reduction on this tooth for an Emax restoration. Now, for the last 30 or 40 years, it was kind of a he said, she said, where the lab technician would say, hey, I don't think you reduced enough on this tooth. And you'd be all, well, I was there and I'm pretty sure I reduced enough. And since we write checks and give them to the technicians, the argument would kind of end there. They wouldn't give us too much pushback. But for the first time ever, for the last 5 years or so, dental laboratories have jumped ahead of dentists in terms of technology. And there's way more technology now in the average dental laboratory than there is in the average dental practice. And as a result, because of the embrace of CAD/CAM by laboratories, it's very easy for them, whether we send a digital impression or a traditional polyvinyl or polyether impression, for them to pour up the stone models, scan it, and then do exactly what you see here, which is click in between our prep and our opposing tooth and see to the hundredth of a millimeter how much we reduced. There's no more he said, she said. We've been caught red-handed under reducing. And they'll be happy to send us a screenshot to let us know that here's what I'm seeing here. And I admit I'm an under prepper. You know, I often tell the story of how I belong to a 12-step group called Under Preppers Anonymous. We meet every Thursday morning at a local church and share coffee and donuts and talk about our struggle and any slips we've had in under reducing that week.